Stop. I know you love that Chinese dog food that you always have. Oh, look at this one. Oh, stop. Oh, you guys, oh, stop it. I love my little doggies, and thanks to China, they are now so much easier to care for. Thank you, China, for putting that melamine, that poison, in the dog food and the baby food, which gives a false read on protein. And oh, stop. You two are going to go outside. I'm warning you. About this other dog, Asia. I tried to pull a tick out of her head, and it was something growing on her head, and I'm twisting on her. She's going, oh, God, please. Wasn't even a tick, see? See, dogs are just getting old. She's passing gas and stinking up the house. I come in, it's like a Dutch oven in here. Smelling feminine smells coming out of her other part there. You come in there, what is that smell? That rotten, dirty, disgusting smell. And it's our dog stinking up our house, making our boudoir smell like old, bunch of rotten prostitutes. Got hardwood floor now, thanks to disability. Forgot that his paws work and can't walk on the wood floor anymore. All of a sudden, he's got to walk with the claws. So destroying everything. And testament to just how stupid some animals can be. He's a smart dog, too. But try to put him on a diet and go out and eat his crap out there. So he's eating up his poop. So, like, why am I going to spend 3 times more money on the fancy food if he's going to eat his crap? I want to get him a hamster, and the hamsters, they're just so disgusting. They're mean, and they bite, and they eat their babies. I decided to get a rat. Well, I said, why'd you get a male? You should have got a female. And I can't get rid of him because the kids already fall in love with him. And they're walking up my arm, and they got these rat testicles dragging up my arm. So, and he got that disgusting rat tail, too. I mean, he's smart and a lovely animal, but I thought the food that you feed rats is like rat poison, which works pretty good. But they got some disgusting ways to kill rats. They got this one sticker trap there. He walks on it and gets his little hand stuck in a sticky tray and the rats all around him. And what a nasty way to die. I mean, oh, boy, these chickens, but they lay real small eggs because I kind of guess they must have real small vaginas. I got 18 chickens and only 3 of them lay, which ain't so good. So I'm like running chicken hospice out there. And I'm going to buy organic food to feed these chickens. Only 3 of them are laying. Cat needs a teeth clean. Okay, got an irregular heartbeat on your kitty cat. So we got to go first to the kitty cardiologist, and that's going to be $400. And I said, you know, I got to remember the way my daddy did. And Mr. Veterinarian, I would like you to know that I love this cat of ours, our family cat. And I'll tell you exactly how much I love this cat. I love this cat $20. Can you work with me? That is the extent of my love for this cat. Talk to the cats and the dogs, and I've got convinced them all to convert to Christian Science. So now I have a bevy of Christian Science animals who are now conscientious objectors to any sorts of surgery. Hey, Scooter, you want to go to the hospital? Oh, no, that's right. I forgot. You converted to Christian Science. So you just suffer through it, buddy. Chickens die, and you bury the chickens. You know, look, the dead chickens all come back to life. The kids are all excited. Chickens are running around. They're not running around. The dogs dug them up, and they're dragging them all over the place. Now you got to rebury dead chicken. And it's not just dead chicken or dead chicken parts there everywhere. 3 little chickies that I raised up for the kids with the hen. And they all perished, which was pretty sad. And I was sort of broken up about it. It was kind of funny. I'm sitting there eating a chicken sandwich. I'm not going to eat any more chicken, any more bird meat, nothing. I'm moving to Buffalo, and they're looking, there's turkey in the refrigerator. I'm like, well, it's not exactly chicken. I don't know if the chicken's mine. And, of course, a chicken will eat chicken. You feed a chicken. You're like, that tastes pretty good. What is it? I'm not going to tell you. And that's what we do. We love our animals because it's a lot easier than loving humans, because humans are disgusting and impossible, and they hold grudges. Chickens don't hold grudges. Dogs don't hold grudges. Cats hold grudges. Blue jays and crows hold grudges, which makes them higher up on the evolution. We learn a lot from our animals, mostly how to clean up their poop. Got the rabbits in the house. The whole room smelled like ammonia. Water bottles dripping and it gets to the food, and there's little tiny bugs flying around. I got a spider web. This is my daughter's bedroom. Like, we got to get these things out of here. I'm not my buddies. I'm going to keep my buddies. Daddy goes over and runs over our dog. We're little kids, I got that memory. That's a pretty common thing. Teach those dogs a lesson. Little bumper biters. The kids didn't train them right. We just didn't train our dogs right. And when the door opens, run in the house, chew something up, and shit on the carpet. That's what my trained dog would do.